Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to my channel, hi, I'm Akanksha. I know you read the title already. So I bought a bunch of makeup recently. You can see my happiness. I've bought so much makeup. I am so excited to try all of it. So yeah, there is drugstore, there's high-end, there's everything. Like, you know, one of my friend went to UK. So, you know, he bought a couple of things, and there's one more friend who was returning from UK. So, you know, I've just ordered things to their places. So I have a lot of makeup in front of me. I'll try to use as much as I can, and if not now, like, you know, they'll be in other videos. I'll post a review somewhere or the other. So before starting, let me be clear, like, before people give me any crap, this is my money. I bought it with my money. I'm not wasting anybody else's money. I bought each and every product right now, which I'll be using in the video, with my money. I have earned it. So if you are that little bitch out there who's thinking extra in that brain, just keep it to yourself. So yeah, I am so excited to try all the makeup. So let's get into the video. Make sure you hit the subscribe button and ring the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post. So let's start off. I have a whole face of makeup. I guess I have everything, but I don't have a primer. So I'm going in with my L'Oreal Base Magic Transforming Smoothing Primer. I love this primer. I use it under all foundations. So I know this is going to be good no matter what I'm using. So yeah, the skin is prepped. So I have two foundations and I'm so excited to try these two. So I have the Fenty Beauty Pro Filter Hydrating Foundation. I have the old one. It is a little too matte, so I thought maybe this would work. Then I have the Milani Conceal and Perfect, and I have the shade Warm Sand, and this is the shade 300. So now which one do I use? Let me just go with the Fenty one. I'll update you guys about the Milani one later. I am super excited to try this foundation. I got the shade 300, but last time I had the shade like 310, sorry. But they were out of the stock, so I was like, you know, just get 300 because I really, really want to try the foundation. The thing is, the Pro Matte one, like the original one, is really nice, but when I have active acne or anything like that, it kind of clings onto the dry patches. So probably this will be really, really nice. So since this is a hydrating or, like, you know, illuminating foundation, which whenever it's in that category, what I like to always do is, it might come as a surprise, but I like to, you know, powder the oil parts of my face, like oily parts of my face. It is not, it doesn't make your, you know, makeup cakey at all. There's a way to do it. So I'm just gonna take my Laura Mercier powder. This is a translucent powder, so, you know, it won't change any color as well. So I'm just going to apply in this and this region. This is the area where I get very oily. So I do this for the LA Girl as well. You know, if I'm using that and I wanted to not get oily during the day because I have really oily skin. So I'm just taking that powder on the sponge very lightly. I'll just apply it and mattify this whole area. This will just make sure that my skin doesn't get oily. Now let's get into the foundation. Let's read about the foundation a little bit. Since I got this from the UK, it is a little more expensive than the US. So I got this, I guess, for £34 or something. So yeah, let's read the description of the foundation. So they say texture is easily worked to obtain a coverage of medium to total while unifying the complexion instantly. As a bonus, this long-lasting aerial texture is visible on the skin. So you can is a foundation available in 50 shades, which is amazing. We already know it's a hydrating foundation, so let's just get into it. So I'm just gonna pump out. Come out. I hope this is not too light. The 310 matches me exactly. But let's see. And anyways, the Fenty foundations oxidize like crazy. I'll show you the oxidization level of the foundation as well. Like, the previous one used to oxidize like crazy. It does have fragrance though. That's some good coverage. I actually love the finish of the foundation. To all the people who click this video thinking it is dollars, I am so sorry. I'm not that rich yet. Maybe one day. We never know. I did apply a lot on my forehead, which I usually don't do. So I hope it doesn't make me very oily. So yeah, that is actually a pretty good coverage, right? So next, let's move on to the concealer. I actually don't have a new product for the concealer. Wait. I know these are available in India, but I did order these from outside because they're just half the price in outside India. So when I order, I order all these from Beauty Bay. Like I ordered it to my friend's house. So these are literally 300 on the Beauty Bay website, and in India there's like 650, I guess 650 or 700, I'm not sure. So I ordered three shades. I ordered number 10.2, 11.2, and 13.5. I absolutely love this concealer, so I know they're going to work. So let's just apply them. I used to have C10 before, but I ordered C10.2 because I thought C10 is a little pinky. The foundation is a little hydrating, like you can see my skin is, you know, shiny, and yeah, so let's see how it is after setting, because obviously I didn't apply powder yet, and maybe the powder will just lock everything in place. So for contouring, I finally got my hands on the Anastasia contour kit. This is the medium one. I am so happy. I guess this is my first product from Anastasia. Yes, this is my first product from Anastasia. So let's just contour using this. I guess I'll go in with this and this. I'll just mix these two a little bit. I didn't try the concealer because I have something else right now, or maybe in the future I will. So I'm just going to take these two shades and go and apply it wherever I usually apply my contour.
Oh, that's a pretty good shade.
I have high hopes for this because I heard a lot about it. So let's see how it works. Oh, it's kind of blending very well. You can see, you can see I don't have much to tell. So yeah, that's the contour blended. I loved everything till now. And let me just show you how much the foundation oxidizes, guys. So can you see, this is what I applied right now, and this is a swatch what I did like 5 minutes ago. So it does oxidize a lot, and now you can see that this is a perfect match to my skin, matched me very, very well. Yeah, so I just wanted to tell you guys that Fenty foundation does oxidize a lot. Just be mindful in case you want to buy that. So let's move on to the powder. I did buy the Fenty Beauty Instant Retouch Setting Powder. I have no idea how this will be. The thing is, I bought the shade Cashew because I thought it'll be the right shade for me. But let's see how it goes. I'm not sure. I feel it'll be like a little dark for my under eyes, but it'll be fine to set my face with. So I'm going to do my old trick of mixing my translucent powder with a colored powder. So I'm just gonna take it on the... I don't know. I'm not sure, guys. I guess this will be a little too dark for my under eyes. Let's just mix my Laura Mercier translucent powder a little bit just for my under eyes, and then I'll use the same powder to set the rest of my face. So make sure there are no creases before setting your concealer. I'm just gonna slightly. Yeah, surely that was a little too dark for my under eyes. Maybe I should have mixed a little more of the translucent powder, but I'm not mad. It is giving a really good finish. It is not patchy, it's not clinging on to anything. I love that it is not giving me a gray cast. Obviously the color powder, so it's fine. Now I'm just going to set the rest of my face with the same powder. I'm gonna just take a fluffy brush. I guess this powder is even a little dark for my skin, but I'm not mad, it's fine, doesn't look that bad. Let me know if you guys want to, see Oh, I am so dumb. I actually bought a new brush set. I should have used all those. I'm sorry, guys. I'll actually use it now. I am so sorry. I did get the BH Cosmetics Lavender Luxe brush set. Let's see how it is. I don't like I got either got this free or the palette free. I'm not sure. I got something for free and I was very happy, so I didn't really care what I bought. And I guess I got the brush set for free. So yeah, these are the brushes. Actually, let me just set the face with the fluffy brush now. I am so particular about my brushes. Like, I absolutely love all the brushes I use. Like, they're literally nameless, but I figured out a way how to use them, so I don't know how this is going to work. Next, let's just move on to bronzing and contouring. I actually ordered a lot of things from Makeup Revolution, like, you know, from the Beauty Bay website, because they have it like for half the price. Like, when I can get it for half the price, why spend so much money in India? So yeah, so I got this Makeup Revolution Ultra Contour Palette. This is the powder one, not the, you know, cream version of it. So yeah, I'm just going to use other shade names. I don't think so. Anyway, so I'm think I'll go in with these two shades, this and this, and I'm just going to contour my face with it. I don't think I can work with this brush. Oh no, I cannot. I like my, you know, contour or blush brush, like, sorry, contour or bronzer brush to be a little fluffy. I like, it's just my choice. I don't like that line of contour to be seen. Oh, they are pigmented. So, you know, just go in with a light hand. Don't take as much as I did. They blended pretty well, though. I am so happy. Everything I bought till now is so good. I did not waste my money. Thank you, God. So yeah, I'm just gonna finish contouring. Not mad, just, you know, go in with a light hand if you want a very soft look, because it is quite pigmented. But yeah, it blended beautifully. So next, I just want to highlight my under eyes a little bit. So I'm going in with the shade number, sorry, brush number 4, and I'm just going to take this shade. It's just like a yellow shade to just to highlight under the eyes, and I'm just going to.
Powder under my eyes color.
Does that make any difference? I don't think so. Maybe actually slightly, a little a tiny bit of highlighting. Next, let's go on to blush. Yes, again, I know, again, I have the Makeup Revolution blush, Reloaded blush in Coral Dream. I don't want to take the brushes from the brush kit because I don't see a fluffy brush other than the powder brush. Or maybe actually I'll just go in with this and see how this works. I just like to, you know, bring the blusher onto my nose as well, just to make it look. My face is looking pretty good, guys. Like, you know, you can see the blush is blended, the contour seems very blended. I do love that the foundation is not like, yeah, it's just been half an hour, but yeah, I don't mind the finish it's giving me. So what I'm going to do is, I'm since the powder is a little dark, I don't want to bake with it. I'm going in with this powder, like, you know, that yellow shade, and I'm just going to bake around my nose with it. By the way, a lot of people ask me which sponge is this. This is the Weiss She brush. I guess their Instagram is Weiss underscore she. So yeah, that's all I'm gonna do. Maybe a little under my eyes as well. I'll dust it off later just to get a little brightened effect. So yeah, that is the contouring done. Let's move on to the lips. I really feel pale, then we can move on to the eyes. So I did get this lipstick from Makeup Revolution. This lipstick, there's no name of the lipstick, guys. So this is the lipstick, looks like this. This is in the shade Rose, I guess 11B. It's a beautiful, beautiful pink shade. So I'm just gonna apply that. उसके पहले आई विल जस्ट अप्लाई दिस लिप लाइनर. दिस द लैक्मे एब्सोल्यूट फॉरएवर सिल्क लिप लाइनर. आई डिड गेट अ लिप लाइनर फ्रॉम देम एज वेल, बट इट्स इन द शेड रेड, सो आई डोंट वांट टू यूज रेड राइट नाउ. आई गॉट द या इट्स हियर राइट हियर. I got the Elegirl lip liner in Forever Red. This is a lip liner. I just got it from there. I know all of these are available in India, but they're way cheaper. They probably I all this would cost me 40,000 in India. I literally got it for 20,000 outside India. So I'm just gonna line. Lip liner. I'm just going to add the lipstick. Ooh, that is actually a super good match. It's exactly the shade of the lip liner. Wow. So yeah, now this is done. Let's move on to the eyes. I do not have a brow product. Actually, I do, but it is for a different video. So I cannot use it in this. And you will see it. And actually, there's a lot of makeup I'm not showing you guys. I'm only showing you guys a little bit of what I bought, because there's a lot of content coming around. And yeah, I just bought a lot of makeup. I mean, it's my job, right? Like, I'm constantly just reinvesting whatever I get, all the money I get, into again making videos for you guys, because it's just like I'm trying, testing, telling you guys if I like it or not. This is basically, I'm showing you most of the stuff which I got from abroad, like not in India. There's a lot of stuff I bought from India as well. Let's just go back to my basic benefit, precisely my brow pencil. This is the pencil I absolutely love. So yeah, my eyes are prepped. I'm just going to go in with this palette. This is the BH Cosmetics Summer in Saint Tropez palette. I was like, when I saw this palette, I was like, just give it to me, because it has so many beautiful colors. I absolutely love the palette. Like, I love the colors. I don't know how it works. So let's do that. I'm going to take the brush number 5. So I'm going to take this shade. This is the shade Sand, and I'm just going to take this shade on a fluffy brush. It does come with a mirror, so it's easier to use. That was a really light shade. It didn't really do much to my eyes. So next I'm going to move on with the same brush into this shade. This is the shade Villa. It's a very, you know, pretty pink pastel type of color. So I'm just gonna add that in my crease now. I'm just going to grab a little smaller brush. Is kind of pretty, probably because I laid down the first shade, it's not getting that much of a pigment. It is blending well though. Let me just grab my normal brush which I use. So yeah, this is my BH Cosmetics brush in number 5. So I'm going to take this and see if it does anything better. So next I'm just taking this shade Cabana, this shade. So I'm taking it in a flat brush. This is the BH Cosmetics brush number 9. I'm just taking a flat brush because I want to pack the color. I want the pigment to be a little strong. So I'm just going to add it. Is it the brush's fault or is it the color's fault? Let me just grab my normal flat brush which I use, which doesn't have any name, which I bought from Shein. Yeah, this is doing, I guess these are definitely buildable type of shades. They are blending very well, but you need to pack a lot of it on the crease for it to appear. They're not patchy, they're beautiful shades, and I like my previous brush better. They are not so pigmented like I expected them to be. This is the first palette of BH Cosmetics that I have used. They do have a little bit of fallout. Just be mindful of that. Actually, the fallout was because of the brush I used. The brush I normally use is not giving me any fallout. So next, I'm just going to take a more pointy brush. This is the brush number 10. I'm just going to take that and blend it out. Yes, definitely The brushes are giving me more fallout than the normal brushes I use. I don't know, that's weird. I can say these are the first time I bought a lot, like, you know, a branded brush set. Because usually I till now I just have those two BH Cosmetics brushes which I showed till now, like a branded, like, you know, a brand brush and a couple of Real Techniques. Other than that, all my eye, nose, contouring, all the brushes are from Shein or Amazon. I mean, it's always good to have better brushes, but I feel my already existing brushes perform better than these. Just saying, I don't know. Let's continue and see. I'm not going to give my final verdict yet. So next, I'm just going into the shade Nightlife. And I'm taking the brush number 8. This is the brush number 8. You can see how it looks. This is the brush number 8. Kind of a fluffy brush. And I'm just going to blend the first color I laid down with this color. Oh, I hate the fact that it went till here. That's the reason I don't use any random brushes. Let me just go in with my Real Techniques brush. This is a brush which comes in a set. This is an eyeshadow brush, base shadow brush. So I'm just going to take the first color I took, the shade Villa, and I'm just going to blend everything out together. The purple is not even seen, guys. Like, what the hell? I know purples are difficult to make, but let me just add that a little bit. Next, I'm just gonna take the same Villa and Cabana under my lower lash line. Not really a fan of the brushes. Anyways, I'll just finish the other eye off camera and I'll be back. Yeah, I did the other eye off camera. I look like a pink. Like a joker with two pink eyes. Anyway, I'm just gonna add a little of the yellow, the shade Intoxicating, on the inner corner. Hopefully that will make the look a little better, and I'm just gonna add it. The eyeshadow palette is very powdery. Be mindful of that. Like, you know, there'll be a lot of fallout. So yeah, now let's add a little eyeliner. I don't have a new eyeliner, so I'm just going to go in with the Makeup Revolution Flick eyeliner. So for highlighter, I'm going to take this shade, like, just mix these two. So yeah, that is the finished look. Let's quickly run down all the products and I'll tell you what I liked, what I didn't like. The Fenty foundation, absolutely love the finish it's giving, but I don't know how long will it wear. If it is going to wear for a very long time, then I'll actually update you guys on my IG if it is going to wear for a very long time. So make sure you follow me on my Instagram. It's Akanksha Kumareli. You can go follow me there. So I love the finish it gave. It's been an hour, well, even 1.5 hours that it's on my skin, so it didn't really make my skin very oily, which is good. So I guess this will kind of make it, like, you know, stay for 4-5 hours without getting oily. I do have oily skin, so that's normal. Then after that, the concealers I absolutely love. I've like, you know, wore these concealers multiple times. I love them. I don't really have much to say about them. Next, the Anastasia contour kit blended very beautifully. You can see how soft my contour is. Looks very beautiful. I love the shades. It's like a universal thing. I got it because I do makeup for clients, and, you know, I needed one kit which I can use on everybody. Next, for the powder is really nice, but the shade is not my shade, so I probably mix a translucent powder, which I always do. It's not a, you know, big thing. Love the finish. It is not making my concealer crease. This is a good thing because I know how the concealer acts, so I know that this powder is making it stay well. I'm going so fast, I don't know for what reason. So yeah, after the powder, then what did we use? Then we used the Revolution contour, Ultra Contour Kit. Ow. What is wrong with me? So next, the Ultra Contour Kit palette. I absolutely love the powders. I thought the highlighters might be a little chunky, but you can see they are giving me a very nice finish. The thing is, it, you know, the two highlighters, one is really light and one is like the golden. So you can probably mix the two and get a very nice highlight shade like I did. Or else the white one is just too white. Love the powders, love the highlighter. The brush set, I'm not really a big fan of the brush set. Maybe I'll use the powder brush or some brush, maybe in case I don't have any brushes for spare, like I didn't clean my brushes or something, maybe I'll use one of or two of them. But other than that, I don't think they're so great. But yeah, not bad. I love the individual brushes which I bought from BH Cosmetics, so I probably will just use them. And we have the BH Cosmetics Summer Saint Tropez palette. I don't know, I've used like 4 shades, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 shades. Not bad, blended well, but I don't know, it just kind of wears off. You can see the yellow pigment is not even there anymore, and the purple was not really being seen properly, so I don't really know. Mixed feelings about this palette. The colors are very beautiful. Maybe if you're someone who would like to build, yes, but the purple is still not so evident for me, and I look like a pink clown with 2 pink eyes. The lipstick, super comfortable actually, it's looking pretty good. Yeah, I guess that's it, you guys. See, like, my skin looks pretty good. I love the finish. Nothing is very chunky, nothing is very patchy. It looks very nice. Everything blended well, the eyeshadow too, but not so great in my opinion. If you like the video, make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and ring the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post. And it would mean the world to me if you subscribe to my channel. So yeah, that's it for today, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Like I already told, I have a lot of stuff. I bought a lot of stuff. There's a lot of content coming. So make sure you hit the subscribe button, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.